Hello everybody, and welcome to my game reviews, dual game review of two games that are both made by Atlus, which is a company I do enjoy. There's two games, Entrain Odyssey 4, the Titans Colossal, I think, along those lines, and then we got wrong thing. Exactly, and Legend of the Titan, and then there's Dragon's Crown. I returned these. I was meaning to do a game review about a week or so ago when I returned them to Gamefly, but unfortunately, I just been lazy as of late. Just kind of been too busy with the new game that I just got, which is Tales of Gyro, which is from the Tales of series, but that's what I'm gonna be talking about later today, and PAVA. So yeah, I'm gonna be up doing a whole shitload of videos today. So if you're a subscriber and you're a fan of me, yay, you have good stuff. But whatever. So yeah, I'm gonna talk about Dragon's Crown and Entrain Odyssey 4 or 5. It's IV. I think that's 4. I'm not sure. I could be wrong though. So whatever. No, actually, I think it's 4, not because 5 would just be the V, and 6 would be the V, then the I. I think. I don't know. I'm not good with Roman numerals, even though I play Final Fantasy a lot. Whatever. Anyway, yeah, both these games are pretty good. I played them both, and I actually defeated Dragon's Crown. I did not defeat Entrain Odyssey 4, which is the game we'll be talking about first. Entrain Odyssey 4, as some of you guys may know, I enjoyed it immensely when I first started playing it. Unfortunately, I just kind of got, after a while, because there really is no character development, you know? Certain characters can develop a little bit, but as soon as they're, like, kind of sort of done, and they join you, you never really hear from them again, like, mysteriously hiding in your party. Which kind of takes me off, but it kind of seems like something that the Fire Emblem would do, but that's just me, you know? But like I said, there's no character development, and there's nothing really to keep you really intrigued into it. I mean, granted, it's very interesting. You get to be your own guild, you get to choose your own characters, you get to make your own characters from scratch, you get to make them, but the only problem is that with this is the fact there's no character development. There's no really story progression, I think. I mean, there is a story. I mean, trust me, there is. I just thought I'd get old as Royal. Beat this area, go on to the next one. Beat this area, go into the next one, go to the final boss, beat the final boss, and move on. I know that's... It just seems so boring and kind of overdone the way they did it, you know? And I did really enjoy that. I apologize, but... whatever. I just didn't seem to enjoy it. I mean, the whole entire... I liked the beginning, I really did. I enjoyed the whole entire idea that you get to make your own. When you like go through the dungeon, you have to plan your little escape routes, you have to plan everything, you have to put where the water was, and all that cool stuff. I liked pretty much drawing your own. I kind of thought it was really cool, and thought it really did take advantage of the 3DS in many more ways than one. I really thought that it took a totally advantage of it, and I'll give it points for that. I thought it was just very immersive, It immersed you, it totally did, which I like. It just didn't get you hooked. And then there's a difference between immersing somebody and getting them hooked. Just because you throw someone in the water and you just throw them in there, does not mean they're going to be does not mean they're actually on the foot, on your fishing line, you know what I mean, your fishing line. Does not mean they're actually on the hook. They're just immersed into the water, you know? They're not actually on the hook. I mean, I've been immersed in games without being hooked on them. And I've been hooked on games without really being immersed on them. It's just... They can definitely go hand in hand, but at the same time, you don't need one for the other. So, just want to get that out of the way. And I like the soundtrack. I like pretty much everything. It just... You know, that's my personal opinion. I personally did not get immersive, but that does not mean I don't think it's a good game. I know it's a good game. I felt it was a good game. Just because I'm not really fond of a game does not mean I know it's not a good game. I don't really like the Call of Duty series, but I won't tell them they suck. I know they're a good game because I can tell whether or not I'm playing a good game or not. I can tell whether or not I'm a okay game. I mean, I've always been with that, but even with anime, some of you guys may know. There's just one anime that I really hate, but I know it's a good anime. I just hate it, though. And I don't really find the Call of Duty series that much, except for the zombies, and I don't really find the shooters in general, but I know that they're good. I kind of underrated Tomb Raider a bit, but that's because I wasn't too fond of it. I mean, I thought it was good. It was good as hell. Hell yeah, it was awesome, but I just wasn't really too fond of it, you know? Everyone thinks that, oh, it's a good game, why don't you like it? Because I didn't like it. I know it's a good game. Doesn't mean I necessarily have to like it because it's good. But just because you don't think you don't like it doesn't mean it's bad either. So just because you think it's horrible does not mean it's actually horrible. If you didn't like playing it, doesn't mean it's not good. So I didn't enjoy it, but I know a lot of people are going to get enjoyment out of this. But like I said, you just don't get really hooked, I felt. But that's just what I felt. I mean, that's just what I saw. I didn't see a bunch of other cool stuff. But I did see a lot of story progression. I didn't finish it, like I said, so I don't know how the full truth. So okay, jump down on my throat and say, hey, you didn't play, but I'm going to give you an honest review of how I felt with it anyway. Sound quality was great. The graphics were pretty good, I thought. I felt it was pretty good. Some people may have found otherwise, but it looked pretty good to me. It looked very good to me. I liked it a lot. But that's just my opinion. And let's see. For unbiased input, I think that the game was overall pretty. Was a good game. I'm gonna go ahead and say, probably should give you more examples of why I think it's such a great game. It's a good game, but when I read, just so you guys know, before I go any further, when I rate something, for me, 5.5 is average. Five is below average, and 6 is slightly above average. 7's good, 4 is bad, and so on and so forth. You get the idea. Yeah, like I said, I believe that I'm gonna go ahead and give this. Yeah, I'm gonna give it an 8. Because I can tell it was a really good game. They put a lot of effort into it. I just wanted to see more story progression. I liked everything about it. Except there was no characters. For me, what makes the story so good is the characters. And there really was no characters for me, you know? To get attached to. I mean, sure, there was the mayor and all that other cool stuff. And also, I felt the story was pretty kind of predictable. I kind of could tell what was going to happen next. I mean, I could have been wrong, and I'm not going to look it on YouTube. I should have, but it just felt predictable. And the odds are, when I feel like a game is predictable, that usually I can usually tell that I know what's going to happen, you know? I mean, I've been wrong many times before, I won't deny that, but, you know, I like it when I can't, when I'm not predicting anything at all. That's why I like it. If I can predict something, I mean, yeah, it's great if they prove me wrong, but, you know, I'm just rambling at this point, so yeah, I'm going to leave it an 8 out of 10. It was a great game, honestly. Like I said, 6 slightly above average, 7's good, and 8's a great game. This is a great game, and I personally think everyone should get a try out of it. However, I don't think everyone's going to get. I think it's a great game for some people. Not everyone. I think for the majority of people are going to enjoy it, especially those who like their RPGs and like being immersed and don't mind all that. Aren't there for the story, and aren't there for all of it. Character development, all the blah, blah, blah. People just don't like that. They just want to play, you know? They don't care. They just kind of skip through the readings. And you can do that. If you're one of those people who just don't really give a damn about the story and just want to play for the gameplay, then go ahead and do it. I believe it's even a better game if you don't even care about that. So go ahead and enjoy that. But that's my review for the first Atlus game. That took a little longer than I expected. But, oh well, I like to explain myself way too much and be way too detailed, but whatever. You guys don't mind that, do you? So yeah, I'm going to get to Dragon's Crown. I enjoy this a lot. I mean, I like side scrolls. I played them when I was younger, but I really played side scrolls that much because I haven't really necessarily been into them, but it's because I really they don't really sites because those are, I've never really been at the arcades. I'm like 18 years old, so naturally I wasn't at the arcade, just kind of just sitting there just arcading like a bunch of other people older than me or 10 years older than me were spending the night and most of their childhood in the arcades. I wasn't like that. I still miss my childhood in a room with a Sony, with a PlayStation or some kind of PlayStation, whatever, play gaming that way or using the game, but that's how I spent my gaming childhood. But I believed when I saw this game, I was like, huh, I'm gonna try this out. You know, and I really did enjoy it. They gave you 6 different character classes. 3 are female, 3 other are male. And I believe I played as a knight, because I like playing as a knight. Because I just see myself as a knight. I mean, I wanted to play as an archer, but they say it was kind of, it was said it was for expert players, and I'm not as expert. And that was my first playthrough, and I always chose the medium mode when I go through the first game. When I go through the second time, that's if I go through the second time, then I choose a harder setting. But I always go on the medium setting, mostly for you people, but yeah, I kind of enjoyed playing it. It was pretty nice. I felt it was a little tedious at times, and a little, it was a little repetitive, but the story moved quick enough where you didn't feel like you're doing it over and over. I mean, it was only a little repetitive, but it was kind of good repetitive, you know, where you don't mind doing the same thing over again. A good example of good repetitive is Pokemon. You're basically catching, training, and going into the gym ladders and being looking forward to becoming the champion. And you do that every single goddamn game. So it's obviously repetitive. People would never get sick of it. People are going to buy the next one. Each Pokemon game is relatively the same goddamn game with different Pokemon. And the concept is always the same, which I love about it, you know? It's just so cool how they did, how Pokemon managed to do that. But that's not a review about Pokemon. That's for another day. I'll review X and Y later, after I get it, but, and I play it, but, yeah, we're down, we're up to Dragon's Crown. Also, I felt like I need to play it, because my username is Sammy15 the Dragon Tame, and, well, I like, as you guys probably can tell, I'm a dragon fan, so I kind of had to play it. I really did enjoy this game, like I said. It was hard at some parts it wasn't. I like the whole entire idea that you can, you play it for the first through time on your own or with characters that you revived, and then the second time you play through it again, but with only harder. And then you get to a different fight different bosses instead, and you go on a different path. There's 2 different paths. You play through the second path on your second time. So basically, you're beating the game all over again. But like I said, it's the good repetitive. I like that. And you get to play online with other people. You get to play with other people, and this can be really fun and really annoying all at the same time. It's really cool. I mean, you can get someone who's like under you, but really not as good as you are. But same time, you can get someone who's really a lot better than you. And I saw people like level 80, and like after like only 5 days of playing it. This is a week after it came out, so I found my 5, and I'm like, holy shit, how the hell do you get that fast that quickly? Like, goddamn, someone grinds like a bitch. I'm the kind of guy that can play through a game only once or twice before they're sick of it. I don't really see why people like play it over and over again. I mean, I did that like once or twice with Pokemon. I only played for Pokemon maximum 3 or 4 times, and people like tell me, I look at people. People give me the like, "Oh, like, wait, you only played it 3 or 4 times? The fuck? I played it at least 1,500 times. Like, I'm not into that. You know, I gotta go attach my Pokemon and just want to delete them. You know, what's wrong with that? I didn't want to create new memories. I just after the 4th playthrough, I was satisfied with my Pokemon. I managed to finally beat the Elite 4. So I, you know. So I really, like I said, I really did enjoy Dragon's Crown, and the sound quality was amazing. The graphics are beautiful. The voice, and there is the only thing I do have the problem with that it was obviously fan service, because half the people you find are either badass, or have like really big tits and like are laying in really lewd positions when you like, especially in dungeons when you like midway through, you're seeing this fairy who's like all spread out with a thin fire shoot. It's like, come on, Atlus. This is honestly fan service. People, and when you do at this little section, it's actually those little pictures are actually cross-paths where you can decide what you get to do next. You get to see a mermaid, you get to see a fairy, you get to see a nun. Come on, Atlus, you know? I know they have a thing for, like, fan service, but seriously, that was obviously fan service there, but I actually did enjoy that part. And when they actually get there at the crossroads, you can actually move your hand around so it touches things, and you can obviously imagine there's a bunch of teenager boys who, like, going, hey, and clicking on the boobs and the vagina and whatnot. Granted, I did the same thing, but I only did it 3-4 times, though. But come on, you would do the same thing, so don't judge. Unless you're, like, one of those serious gamers, I mean, which, honestly, I don't like serious gamers. I like, you know, gamers who, like, don't mind taking it easy and just kind of, like, play it because they like playing the game, you know? But at this point, I'm just really rambling. I thought the gameplay was smooth. I had a few trouble with little few things. There's a few things I did not like that I thought was... I thought the difficulty in some parts was kind of harder than it should be. The character development system I did like a little bit. I thought it could have been a little bit improved on. I had one or two issues about that, but I'm not really going to go into detail. Yeah, I just thought that this game was basically made to be a cool side scroll with pretty graphics on late in the in this generation's console's life, and it was really cool what they put out. I mean, I'm gonna go ahead and say this was a really good game. I think everyone, you probably could be within the weekend, so I suggest for those people who have like a 3 or 4 day weekend or have a bunch of days off, to grab this game and whenever the day you start having your days off and just kind of play it through the whole entire weekend, or on a Friday night, or the night you start having your weekend, I think you should get this game and just like play, because I think you really should play this game. I mean, it shouldn't take more than like 3 or 4 days. If that, I mean, you might actually want to play this game more than 3 or 4 days because it's so much fun. You really only need to beat the dragon, the Grand Jay, the final boss, and then the game's beaten. But you can still play after that, of course. A bunch of other stuff to do after that. People love this game. I mean, I personally think it's a really great game, but I just don't really see the point of playing it over and over again, especially since I'm renting and I don't really feel the intention of buying it, so I returned it so I can play a few other games, which I'll get to later on today. So for my final review, my final verdict on this game, I'm going to give it an 8.4. A pretty great game. You know, some people give an 8.5. Toonami gave an 8.5, but I think the difference between an 8.4 and an 8.5 for me is that if I wanted to keep it longer and I felt the need to keep it a little longer, I've had tons of fun. And also, I really did think it was a little too much fan service. It was too blatant for me. I mean, plus I'm not really big into boobs, you know. I like boobs, but I like smaller boobs. Go ahead, sue me for that. But you know. So yeah, I think I gave it an 8.4, and I'm giving Entrain Odyssey 4. Colossal giant, blah blah blah, whatever. An 8. So, yeah, that's my final verdict on these games. If you don't like it, well, suck it. I don't care. I mean, you can play other games, and I'm gonna give you another review later on one of the animes I was watching. So, please tell me what you thought about these games, and please, you should probably play. I recommend playing both of these games. I mean, I think Entrain Odyssey is for people who have a 3DS and looking for something other than the new Pokemon games or the Fire Emblem games, or played both Animal Crossing and Fire Emblem too many times to count and just want something new. This is for you. I think you should play this game. It's a lot of fun, and if you like being immersed totally into it and don't really care about the story, more of the gameplay you like, this game is for you, you should probably play that. And for Dragon Quest Crimes, for those people who like side scrolls a lot and like new graphics and also like fan service, so I'm guessing this should probably be around for like college age guys. Or a little slightly older than me, but also kind of pervy as well. So it should be for those of you. For those of you, I think Entrain Odyssey is more for the younger audience, for the preteen audience, but that's just me. You guys can play these guys regardless, so, but that's my honest opinion. If you don't like it, well, I'm just rambling at this point, I think. That's my game review for both of these games, and have a nice day, and listen to, I'm going to end this out with my friend, Sick Puppies. And let's put the song There's No Going Back off their album Connect. It was released this year in 2013, so enjoy the rest of the song. Not rest of the song, but have a nice day. Where's it, the button? Where's the button? Where's the button? Okay, there's the button. Turning left and turning right, stuck in how I always waited by. You can't regret what you don't decide. Should've stayed, should've let go. Should've, could've, means you'll never know. Whoa, oh, oh. Whoa, oh, oh.